I think that I'm evaluating like everybody else. So there is something that is so stronger and so bigger than what anybody could expect. It's something that is stopping all the world. So it's not, you don't have to feel unlucky because, I mean, everybody is the same situation. And I think like a coach, I'm trying to, I cannot see my player. I cannot train my player, but we try to be in contact with them and we try to keep them busy and to keep them fit. That is the most important time. So, I mean, I don't know whenever this season will keep going or will finish, but I mean, then there will be again a new start for this season or for the next season. So a professional athlete can never stop to be on shape. No, so we are organizing very nice stuff with our athletic trainer, and we give to the player every day one homework to do at home, and it's always about 30, 40, 50 minutes of physical activity, all exercise they can do at home, and they're also challenging themselves with this, you know, making a ranking with the quickest, with the one that make the most repetition, you know. So, and it's fun. It's fun. The players are enjoying that and they're trying to do this. And me, I try to use this time for myself the better I can. So I'm using the early morning for myself. And then from when my daughter wake up, I have no more life, so I'm pretty much more busy than in my normal life, you know, because me and Bar, we take care about Alison, and this age, you know, she always requires one of us, you know. The moment that she can play alone are really, really small and not many and not long, and so we are trying to entertain her as much as we can, and this requires a lot of energy, a lot of time, but it's a good energy and good time. Much more difficult. I mean, coaching, I can stay in the gym 24 hours and I know I can change 24 drills, you know, so I can always have something to do and I can find always something to say and to correct anybody, you know. But I mean, to entertain a child without opening television, and that's what we don't want to do, until of course we do, but we only do one time a day in the night, you know. So from 8 o'clock to 8 o'clock without television, that you always have to find something to make her happy and to enjoy air. And now it's not also possible to go outside. So because she loves parks and she loves to walk near the seaside over the rocks, but we cannot do that now also anymore, you know. So it becomes always more challenging. But it's fun. I mean, it's really challenging, you know. So you have to find out something to do anytime. But I think I'm more successful on, I think I can work like an actor after this, because every day I am one Disney character that she give me, you know. So if she's Princess Pamuk, probably I am the prince, or if she's PJ Mask, I am one of the other PJ Masks, and she invented stories in the house of monster that are following us and we have to run and hiding and so on. So this, I'm doing pretty well. I love the season because it was really exciting from the beginning, because so many new players, you know, that give always excitement to the coach, to the staff, to the fans, to everybody, because you have new players, so you have new person that you have to know, you have new person that you have to make them better, and you have to new person that you have to put together to create a team, you know. So a lot of challenging at the beginning, and was one of the seasons that we started, you know, with not too many, I don't want to say we didn't have goal, but I mean, we didn't say we have to win everything because we are the strongest team in the world. No, we started to say, okay, Conegliano is very strong, Exacibas is very strong, and Scandic is also a very strong team, and Fenerbahce is really strong, Galatasaray is better than last year, Novara is always dangerous. So we really started with, you know, with the idea that, okay, they are big, we don't know where we can finish because there are so many strong teams, you know. At the end of that, you know, we lost one match in Champions League and one match in Turkish League, you know, so we are pretty very happy about that. And also we did a very, very good club world championship. You know, that this bronze medal means a lot because we play with a really very young team and very new team. And so I was an amazing season. It was really one of the seasons that you start without really expecting nothing. And you, when you watch back, you see you collect a lot. You know, I think I already told you, but I mean, or somebody else. We started the season with a clear message, you know. So that was, we want to build a new house over the same rock. You know, so the rock is what means the stability of the club, the stability of the history of the club, what the club did and how the club, you know, learned how to work. And the new house was, of course, the new team that have to install, you know, himself into this rock. And I think we did a very good step in building this new house. Yeah, I think that they're handling pretty well, you know, because I think, you know, that they needed also this, you know, because for a player that is always in national team and club, you know, is pretty hard. You know, you start to have a moment where I don't want to say you really hate volleyball, but it's really, I mean, there are moments in their life that really enough, you know, volleyball, finish national team, start the club, finish the club, national team, go to China, come back to Turkey, go to Japan and go to Serbia and come back to Turkey and go to Russia and go to Italy. I mean, always volleyball, traveling. And I think for most of them, you know, and is really nice also to have some nice time near your dears and without any, I have to train today, I have to match, I have to win, I have to do, okay. I think that so far they're enjoying, you know, and it's also very nice that then many of them, when I wrote, they said, Giovanni, I miss volleyball so much. I was never thinking I can miss volleyball because volleyball was here, but now I really miss volleyball. You know, that's pretty normal and pretty good. You know, miss too, I miss volleyball, you know, so I miss, but sometimes me and Bar, we start to play at home, you know, a little bit. Alison, I still don't convince her, but me and Bar, we take a ball, we do a little bit together because we are used. I mean, we are used to have the ball in our hand to all our life. You know, if I go back in my last 30 years of my life, I touch one ball in my hand basically every day, you know, I mean, or 340 days a year at least, you know, so then stay 2 weeks without having this ball in your hand. It's pretty weird. It's pretty very, very unusual, you know, so we are all missing. We are all trying to find the best from that, you know, and I think that is very good time for individual growing, you know, and actually I was reading something funny, you know, that I don't know who wrote one of the million things you read in Twitter and Instagram that was telling the people that are complaining about which movie to watch more, which book to read more, what thing to do more at home. They are for sure, they are not parents, you know, because actually, you know, I also started with, okay, I want to read this book, I want to watch this movie, you know, I want to watch one movie from the beginning of the quarantine. And still I didn't start 1 minute of this movie, you know. And really, I have to wake up very early to have at least from 6 to 8 is 2 hours that I can do my stuff, you know. So I don't want to watch a movie, but I do sport and I try to read at least something because it's not easy, but it's really the right moment, you know, to grow and to learn new thing and to study more. You know, for example, now in the morning I made in one course online about quick reading, you know, because to finish a book normally I need 3 months, you know, I try to learn how to read faster and also learning. And when I finish this, I want to start a new one, you know, so doesn't have to be necessary volleyball, you know. Yeah, but there have to be something that will make myself better, and so that's the way I try to use this time. Absolutely, it's absolutely like this. You know, that's why, you know, I think that every situation in the life you have to try to win. You know, that doesn't matter because we are used to do that every training, every match. You know, doesn't matter if the other team is stronger. Doesn't matter if I have 10 player injury, you know, but I enter in the court and I try to win. So in this situation, we have to do the same. So we have to finish this Corona time with a win, you know, and first win is to stay healthy, you know, and keep other people healthy, you know. That's why, you know, it's very important to take all the precaution. And the second win is to grow like a person, you know, and if you finish this person, that you are a better person because you learn new things, because you really, you increase your knowledge about everything, you know, related to your work or not related to your work. Just I'm really talking now about personal growth, and you finish this time and you have better knowledge of yourself, you have better knowledge of the skills you need in the daily life, you know, you install better habit, a better daily routine, you know. I think this time, and after you will finish, and then you have, oh, this Corona, I think this Corona was a big win. And in this win, you know, you have to put also the personal relation, because you have really much more time to spend with wife, with husband, with families, with sisters, with daughter and child. So this is also a very nice time to build better relationship and learning each other better and more. Because, of course, I'm not talking about the player, everybody, you know, even coaches, even the people that have the best job in the life, you know, I mean, even if you speak with a singer, you know, that there is one moment that he said, hey, I cannot do a concert anymore, I cannot go over there and keep smiling and keep singing, and, you know, he's tired because I'm doing every day, you know. And this kind of moment, they will make you appreciate more what you have, for sure, you know. So when before was, oh, I have to go training again, I have to stay in the gym again, I have to push hard, I have to jump maximum, oof, this is hard. And it is hard. I mean, I'm not telling that it's not hard, you know, but for sure, next time that you left this thing, you said, oof, but also staying at home one month and that, this was even harder, you know. So thanks God that I can do again my job. So I think that this will give to all of us, you know, a big appreciation of what we have, you know, and learn to complain less, and also learn that even if we are doing something that for us is very, very, very important, but you see, it's not so important because a virus can keep everybody at home. And so it's much more stronger than anybody of us. So we have to all calm down and come back to our very, you know, level of human being status and start to be more humble and start just to appreciate more what we have. Wake up early, because, you know, is then if you, first of all, because I really believe that this gives you much more energy during all day. Second, because after it will be very difficult to, you know, come back to a normal life when you used to stay 1 month waking up at 10 or 11. Second, doing sport regularly. This is the most important things, really the most important. First of all, because now everybody has time, you know, so there is no more excuse. You know, I know many people that, come on, why you don't make sport? Oh, Giovanni, I cannot. I have to work. I have to travel. I stay 2 hours in the car and then I have to come back. And it's correct. Some people really don't have time to work. I mean, if you travel 2 hours, you know, to go your home and want to go your job and want to come back, and then you have to work 8 hours a day, then it's difficult. Not that everybody have this energy, you know. So now a lot of people don't have excuse, you know. So go outside and run. You know, everybody can do that. You cannot go in the park, but you can go in the walk side. And now the streets are not crowded at all, you know. Or you open an internet, there are million, you know, a very nice workout. You know, you go to Google, you put hotel room workout or home workout or million application, that everything you can do without equipment. So do it, and do it for at least 40-45 minutes every day. I suggest also to everybody yoga, because everybody needs more elastic body, more flexible body, and more stretching is very good for everybody because we see too much, all of us, you know, even the people do sport because we stay too much in front of computer sometimes. So the sport, I think, is really mandatory. The third thing, I believe, read one book every week. I think, again, now a lot of people have time. But don't spend too much time reading only fiction, you know, because I think when you read fiction, it's okay, you know, for clean your mind. But then, I mean, don't stay nothing, you know, don't give you much more than a little bit of a relax. That is also good. So read book where they can teach you something, and there are millions. Read biography of great people, or listen audiobook. I mean, I think doesn't change nothing, but I think audiobook is more if you want to go for a nice walk in the nature. That is also very nice, keeping the distance. And the fourth thing, that spend good time with the people near you. So don't make social distance at home. Just keep the social distance out of home, but at home make very social, I don't know how to call it, but stay close as much as you can. And you ask me five, and I think it's also time to make one online course to learn new things, you know. So there are really a million free payment, you know, but there are so many very nice way to grow like yourself, to learn new things, you know, to learn about nutrition, to learn about mental skills, to learn about body, to learn about, you know, leadership, growing. And, you know, you don't need to be a coach to be a leader. You know, everybody can be a leader, means doing the great of you can do every time in your job, you know. So this is, everybody can learn a lot about that also, you know. So these are my five tips. Yes, I'm watching basically nothing right now. Actually, the only thing I'm watching now is a online course about, yeah, I told you about quick reading, and then I'm not watching much. What I suggest to everybody, I mean, I'm reading a couple book of Robin Sharma. That is something that I'm learning a lot. I think it's great, one of the great book, that biography are really interesting, you know, that actually I'm doing mostly in audiobook, you know, but reading about Nelson Mandela or Martin Luther King or Madre Teresa, you know, why these people become legendary, you know, and then you read Gandhi, you know, why Gandhi became Gandhi, you know. I didn't know, because I have, before I started to listen to his story about an audiobook, you know, and that was really very, very interesting, you know. Steve Jobs was an amazing, interesting book to read, you know. This for me is very inspiring, you know, to really read what this amazing people was able to do, you know. So this is a very nice suggestion that I can give, you know. So of course there is also Agassi book, many people already read, but I would go, if I'm to sport people, I suggest to not read about sport people. To sport people, I suggest to read about not sport people that achieve great stuff in their job, to learn from a very different perspective.